Hey guys, so today's video is going to be a really super chatty get ready with me. I'm going to be pretty much just proper chatting through my makeup and stuff for my All Time Low concert. I do a super chatty one because I haven't done a chatty one before, like for a concert, so here I am. I'm gonna do a chatty one. Planned my makeup. My last get ready with me, I hadn't actually planned my makeup. I was completely winging it, but this time I have all my makeup in this box here. I did this makeup look yesterday, so Tuesday, and I absolutely loved it, and it'll probably turn out different because I'm going to do a few things differently, but yeah, this is the makeup that I'm going to be wearing on Friday for my All Time Low concert. I wanted to go super dramatic and stuff because I am actually meeting the band, which is insane. I'm going to talk more about it in the video because I'll be chatting about it. Let's just get into doing it. So, I'm going to be using quite a few palettes, I'm not going to lie. I'm using four different palettes because I'm extra. Tarte Lip in Bloom palette. The Tarte Energy Noir palette, just one shade from this one. The MUA Poptastic palette. The Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance palette. This brush from 17. Okay, so I decided to zoom like basically right in and I've refocused it. So, you know, sorry if this side is like super dark. I haven't got like a light like beside me this side, but I've got the window this side of me, so I kind of look a bit washed out. This is what the brush looks like. Yeah, and I'm gonna use the shade Sweetheart from the Tarte Lip in Bloom palette. Oh, I need to prime my eyes first because I didn't prime my eyes yesterday and I regret it. Using the Collection Less of Perfection concealer, because why the fuck not to prime my eyelids. Freedom Pro Camouflage Paste. So now I'm gonna go in with Sweetheart. Okay. Oh my god, I forgot tape. I'm such a mess. This video is already a mess. I'm actually using washi tape. I hate having tape on my eyes. But it's the only way I can get my eyeshadow like super sharp, so yikes. The washi, I literally can't, the washi tape is from Paper Chase, if you wanted to know. I feel like that's really irrelevant, but I'm gonna talk about meeting All Time Low because Chara and her friends got meet and greet. So I'm gonna tell you the story about us meeting All Time Low technically like twice within the space of like an hour. Basically, as you guys know, I saw All Time Low 3 weeks ago on the first show of tour, which was in Hammersmith in London. So I went to that, obviously. And I went to the signing, so I met them at the signing, like we were all three of us did. The Modern Renaissance, using the shade Love Letter. Oh. I'm using Real Techniques Base Shadow Brush because it's perfect for my small little crease. Moving on. So, we go to the sign-in. And, this is why I can't do chat to get ready with me, because I can't chat whilst doing my makeup. Oh my god. We go to the sign-in. And we meet All Time Low and we're like, oh my god, we met them and stuff. And as soon as we get out of the sign-in, Charlie, my friend, obviously my best friend, is like, right, that's it. We're going to the Brixton signing. We get back to the hotel and Charlie literally books Brixton signing there and then. Like, no word of a lie. But then, because at this point we were like convinced that we were not gonna get meet and greet, because at the beginning of tour, all three of us, me, Charlie and Rita, like, obviously signed up for All Time Low's meet and greet, that this like thing called Hustler meet and greet, and we were like convinced we weren't gonna get it because we like all have like super bad luck and we just weren't gonna get it. Oh my god. Saturday, I was with my boyfriend and I get this call from Charlie, and I was watching Misfits, and I get this call from Charlie and I'm like, what's going on, like, are you okay? And Charlie literally says, we got meet and greet, and there and then, I swear, those words came out of Charlie's mouth, and I literally had tears in my eyes. I was like, are you having a laugh? Like, are you joking? I thought Charlie was joking. But they weren't. They were not joking. Because my name is on that list. If you look at that list, my name is on it. I'm gonna go in, oh god, go in with the shade Red Ochre. And yeah. Yeah, we get meet and greet. So I look on the website. And I see my name on the freaking list. My name is on the freaking list. And I'm meeting all time out. Like, what the fuck? So we get to like meet them. Basically what it is like a 30 person meet and greet. And the people got randomly chose. So we got like randomly chose to meet them, which is insane. That's the story of how we are now meeting Otomo like twice. So we go to the signing first and I'm literally gonna say to Jack like, yo, see you later, bitch. Yeah. People shut up, for God's sake. People are messaging me. Like, I should have texted them and said I'm doing a video, like, shut the fuck up. Rhea, stop. Oh my God, shut up. It's like super red, I love. This is kind of like a halo eye, so I'm gonna just take it in my inner corner as well. Blend, blend, blend. Yeah. Also, technically I'm meeting Otomo like 3 times within the space of like 2 days because I am going to Radio 1. When I'm filming this, it's Wednesday. And Otomo at Radio 1 on Thursday. So tomorrow. And I'm pretty sure I'm going. What the hell? They're going to Radio 1 because they're doing this live lunch thing. And I'm going, what the fuck? So I'm literally gonna meet them again. This look actually has turned out more red than I expected, but I like it. I was gonna use the dark pink shade in the Poptastic palette, but I don't think I am now because I want to kind of keep this look and like dark. And I'm gonna go in with Lida, which is this one from the Tarte in Bloom palette, and just darken it up a little bit and just focus that on the outer kind of thing. What you call it? I don't know. I'm honestly still shook that I'm going to meet Jack Barragat because he's my fave. He's my fave from Otomo. But I'm like honestly shook that I'm going to meet all of them, to be fair. Because it's insane. Usually I have like music blasting. But obviously I don't right now because copyright. Now I'm going to go in with the scary shade. I'm going to go in with black. Oh, I literally can't see anything. And this brush from that I got with the Modern Renaissance palette. And I'm taking the Tarte Energy Noir palette, it looks like this. And I'm taking the shade Lunar Eclipse, which is just matte black, to be honest. And I'm just gonna put that on the outer kind of edge. Basically where we put Lida. So we're gonna just take it here where we also put Lida and blend it. Take this brush back and just blend that. I'm just gonna take the Real Techniques Deluxe Crease Brush and just blend everything out. It's got no extra product, just blending it just to make sure all the colours are blended in with each other, because otherwise it's gonna look shit, isn't it? Really, I'm not gonna do any liner with this look, by the way, because it's quite dramatic anyway. I don't want to ruin my eyes with trying to attempt wing liner, because it just doesn't work, does it? Really, it's gonna take a little bit of the Collection Last Perfection concealer using the Real Techniques detailer brush, and I'm literally just gonna wipe some concealer on my brush like this, and take it in the middle of Tarte in Bloom, and I'm taking the shade Firecracker. I absolutely adore this shade. Spray it with some NYX setting spray, because I don't own MAC Fix Plus, so I can't do that shit, so I'm just gonna do it with this instead, because I feel like the same concept applies, right? That is the eyeshadow done. Like I said, I'm not doing eyeliner, so I can just take off the tape. Ooh. And that is what it looks like. So, like I said, it's just got like a proper strap. Sharp edge, which I like. That was the whole kind of point of putting tape on my eyes. And now I'm actually gonna wear some lashes, but first I'm taking the Benefit Their Real mascara and I'm just gonna put a little amount on, like not major, just gonna put a little coat on, because I find it really hard to apply lashes when I have mascara on, because I have quite long lashes anyway, so literally it was like two swipes of mascara. And now these Scarlet lashes from Huda Beauty. I absolutely adore these lashes. They are my favorite right now, even though I don't own many lashes actually, but still, like, these are still my fave. They're so beautiful. They're very dramatic, but I'm going out, so I feel like it's acceptable. I'm gonna use this little mini duo glue that I got with my Ardell lashes, because duo glue is supposed to be the best, isn't it? I don't even know. Don't actually have any tweezers, so this could be fun. I struggled when I was doing, oh my god. I might have to go and steal my mum's tweezers in a minute, because I can never do this eye. Oh my god, the lighting is changing so much. I'm sorry for the shit lighting, but okay, this is quite hard. Okay, so I did my lashes off camera because I used my mum's mirror. My mum has this really cool mirror in her room. I press a button and it lights up, so I used that, and she has tweezers and I don't. Absolutely stunning. I love them so much. And yeah, they work perfect with this look because there's no winged liner. It's kind of focusing on the lashes, which is what I want. And obviously the eyeshadow is quite like dark and stuff, so it's pretty. Okay, so I've solved the issue of it being like too dark on this side. Like I said, now I'm gonna do my brows. Recently been doing my brows before my like foundation and stuff, just because I feel like if I mess up on my brows, it's fine because I can like rub it away or like put concealer over it, but it's obviously harder to correct a mistake if I've already done my foundation, which is also why I do my eyes before my foundation as well. Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Pomade. You guys know the drill, that's what I've used since I've got back from my holiday. This is all I've used. If you follow my beauty Instagram, I swear I don't even have to say what I've got on my brows anymore, because I it's all I use. And I use the number 12 brush from Anastasia as well. It's in the shade Chocolate, by the way, just in case you weren't familiar with my shade. So I'm probably not gonna be able to talk during this because it's honestly stressful as fuck. I'm gonna get my brows to match. It's so hard. I'm not even joking. Okay, so that didn't actually take me that long. It's actually okay. Like, look at the difference. Honestly, look at the difference in my eyebrows. How tragic. Now it's the most stressful part, is trying to get this one to match this one, which is always a mission. I'm telling you now, it's naturally don't match, which is really annoying. makes it harder for me to actually match them when I've when I'm doing my friend Rhea's mastering me again. Rhea, I know you'll be watching this when it goes up. I can fix it with concealer. They literally don't match, but we're just gonna move past it, okay? I'll try it, okay? Just deal with it. Move on to the face. So am I too like zoomed in? I think this is fine for face. So I'm using the Benefit Professional Primer because again, I've used this like every day since I bought it. I use this for when I go out, obviously. Duh. Try the, I'm just gonna use the viewfinder as a mirror for now. For just a second. I really wanna try the Too Faced Hangover Primer. Because, I don't know, people say it's good. It smells real good. I like the smell of it. I'm gonna mix two foundations. I'm gonna mix a drugstore and a higher end foundation. So for the majority of the look, I'm using the MAC Pro Longwear. It's kind of not my shade, but honestly, why? I don't even care. And I'm also using Rimmel Match Perfection. This is in the shade NC30, so I mean, I did get it when in the summer. I got it matched in the summer, so that's kind of why. I'm like a little bit more pale now. Can you see? But like, I swear like my neck is like a different colour to my like chest. It's really weird. Your Techniques Expert Face Brush to blend everything in. MAC foundation. This was like £24. I've never spent so much on a damn foundation. I don't know why I did it. I'm kidding. I do know why I did it because it's good. The Rimmel Match Perfection as well. So you can see they're two completely different colours. Yeah, the MAC one's quite orange compared to the Rimmel one. So I'm just going to take the rest that's on my hand on my brush. And I've got to get my mirror back. I'm just gonna blend. Honestly, I've been using my beauty blender so much, I forgot that I love this brush. So I've got to bring it down on my neck so much. It's tragic. Tragic, really, isn't it? So, anyway. Like I was saying, I don't even know what I was saying. Was I saying anything? I don't think I was. 6 feet in the stars? Yeah, definitely, Charlie. That's definitely what it's called. 6 feet under the stars in my head. How is my camera battery going to die? Are you having a laugh? Are you actually joking? My camera battery is flashing at me. Fuck. I'm taking that long to do my makeup. Now I'm gonna have to wait before I do the rest of my makeup. How tragic. This is when you need another fucking battery. I need another camera battery for when things like this happen. But do I have one? No. I'm just gonna wait to see if it like actually dies. I don't know how long it takes before it actually like dies. We're just gonna chance it, okay? Probably gonna edit this bit out because it's tragic. Blending foundation is honestly so boring. It's like the bane of my life. See, I like adding the Rimmel Match Perfection into this because it makes it like slightly more dewy because the MAC one is matte. But adding the Rimmel one just gives it a bit more kind of shine to it, I guess. Like you can see, but when I wear the Rimmel one on its own, it's like super glowy here and like everywhere. It's super like dewy. But yeah, blended my foundation now, so I like that. That's kind of why I put in my thing. Put in the Rimmel one because it makes it kind of dewy, which I like. It's gonna go in concealer. That's not concealer. This is concealer. The same one I used. I've been using the whole time. It's Collection Last Imperfection. I'm just gonna put that under my eyes. obviously, as highlight. There we go. And then I'm going to take this brush from eBay and just blend it in. Just blend it in. But I'm also going to take that detailer brush just to blend in the concealer that's up by my eyeshadow, because yesterday I did it and I ruined the sharpness of the look. It just gives a super like highlighted look, which I like. Look good for Jack Barrack, yeah? Am I right, ladies? Oh my god, I hate myself. I'm still shook that my camera battery is flashing at me right now when I'm in the middle of doing my fucking makeup. Like, why pick now, camera? That is the face. That's like concealer and foundation. And now I'm gonna take the e.l.f. loose powder to set my under eyes. So I just spill it everywhere. So I just kind of shake it to get some out, which is probably not a good idea, but I'm just gonna go with that. Beauty blender, and just get a little bit on the beauty blender. And I'm just gonna put it under here. And I'll wipe it away in a minute. It's kind of like baking, but it's not really baking because I can't do that. If you know what I mean. I can't bake, so this is as close to it as I'm ever gonna get. Meet me on Team Street. Just basically everywhere where I would put the concealer. You really need to see an idea, this is embarrassing, so cover it so well. Oh. Okay, so that's that done. It's just a random brush from eBay that I found. And then I'm just gonna brush it away. Actual joke that my camera has decided to start flashing at me when I'm trying to film a video. Why? Somebody please help me, because I'd love to know. I've got two contour palettes here, drugstore and high end. But yeah, I'm gonna take very lightly. First, going to take this middle shade from the Revolution palette, contour palette, and just kind of contour with that. I take the shade Fawn, middle one from the Anastasia contour kit, and go over that. This is going to be like a super bronzed look, by the way, because I'm loving that look lately. I'm going to take this brush. This is gonna blend that a little bit. Yeah, I'm gonna take the what's it called, Too Faced chocolate bronzer, and just bronze up the rest of my face with that and heel. I love this bronzer so much because it smells like chocolate, but it just, oh, I love it. Obviously I bought it in Sephora when I went to Sephora. I honestly miss Sephora so much. I wish I could go back, but I can't because I'm not in America. I'm gonna do highlight. So I'm taking the Sleek highlighting palette in Precious Metals Platinum, I think. This shade here, I'm just gonna use that and just put it on. I got my finger and just apply it to here and up here as well, so like all the way down, and do the same over here, so then it's super like glowy as fuck. Hi, so I'm back, right. I've put my jacket on now, by the way, because I got cold. Okay, so I just literally had to go and sit downstairs with half a face of makeup on whilst I waited for my camera battery to charge. So I don't know if I actually filmed me putting my highlight on, but if it didn't, I'm using the Sleek face thing, whatever it's called. I'm just going to put a bit more on because why not? You can never have too much highlight. I'm going to be so extra with highlight today, by the way. Like, I'm going to put like quite a few different ones on because why not, eh? So as well as that, I'm taking the Revolution contour palette again, and I'm taking my little Real Techniques angled highlighter brush. Also, if the lighting's changed, it's because it's obviously got darker. My light is literally like here. That's why it's like dark over this side, because the light is like here, but I'm facing more to this side, so you know. I'm taking this highlight shade here. It's so nice. And I'm just going to put that over the top. Look at that glow. I'm also going to add a shade from the Anastasia Moonchild Glow Kit. I'm going to add the shade. Wait. So I'm using the shade Star from the Anastasia Glow Kit, and I need that mirror back because the Anastasia one doesn't have a mirror, to make it super duper glowy. Got a Snapchat from Rhea. Look at that highlight. I love. Okay, so that is that. That is highlight. Now I'm gonna go and do, like under the eyes, like eyeshadow under the eyes. So I'm gonna zoom back in. Use Sweetheart from the Tartlet, palette. Yeah. I literally have nothing else to chat about. Little bit of Love Letter from the Anastasia palette. Just adding that. Because the tension, you can totally see that my eyelash is coming off. Just ignore that. And then with Red Ochre from the Anastasia palette as well. Yes, and now, what was the last shade that I used? Lida. I don't think I'm going to add that. So in my last Get Ready With Me, I said this was the detailer brush, and then I said I couldn't remember the name of it, but it's called the Accent Brush. Lunar Eclipse again from, which is this one, from the Tarte palette. From the Tarte Energy Noir palette. I just run that underneath. Go in with the NYX. What is this called? Jumbo Eye Pencil in Black Bean, and just run that along my waterline. Because, you know, Revolution Highlight, and just use that as an inner corner. We're nearly done, we're not fully done. Now I'm gonna just bronze up a little bit more. Hoola Bronzer by Benefit. I have this mini one because I got the Do the Hoola set in on the plane when I went to America. Makes you look a little bit more bronze. It's done. Okay, I'm gonna zoom back. Yeah, I'm gonna zoom back out. I'm gonna do my lips, obviously. So I'm taking the what's this called? Lip liner, Lasting Finish lip liner in the shade, is it Spice? Yeah, in the shade Spice, and I'm just gonna line my lips. Jeffree Star liquid lipstick in the shade Androgyny, and just put that on my lips, obviously. Duh. done. Yeah. We could make forever after all, finding the gold in our darkest moments, watching the roads turning into white roses, roses. We don't ever have to leave these walls. Oh, I forgot something. I'm using the NYX setting spray to set my face. Jumpy on my hair because it looks like shit right now. Literally looks like absolute shite, doesn't it really? So for my hair, I'm literally just leaving it down.